Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of AI360. I'm so excited for this one because we have Jim, our head of applied AI, joining us. Jim, do you want to do a quick intro?
Yeah. Hey, everyone. Jim Rowan. I head up our applied AI SGO here at Deloitte. Really excited for this opportunity. I love the podcast. Been listening to it last year and really excited about where we're going to take it this year. One of my roles is really helping our clients drive value from the AI solutions in the marketplace. So spending a lot of time with clients, having those conversations. I also am helping our firm think through how we transform Deloitte internally with the use of AI and generative AI technologies. So I'm sure that might be a hot topic for us in the future. And then finally, I'm working with our teams to think through innovation. So how do we innovate around this really cool technology and incorporate it into our services going forward? So a lot of great topics for us to cover in the future. And Rowan, thanks for having me on.
Absolutely, Jim. So in this role also, you hosted our first ever AI ecosystem summit. So do you mind telling us a little bit about that?
Yeah, wow, what a great event. So if you think about what our alliances do, they have a great events, you know, they have the major conferences and we get to join and attend and be part of those conversations. Well, in this case, we turn the tables and we invite our alliances sort of to our house, if you will, and brought 500 of our PPMDs together to have a great conversation about what we're seeing in the marketplace, what are the client challenges that everyone's facing, and how do we better understand the alliance roadmaps that they have so that we can incorporate that into our advice that we give to our clients. So really cool session that we had just a couple weeks ago.
That's awesome. What were some of your takeaways from that session? I know we were together for almost 3 days.
Yeah, there were a lot of takeaways. I think number one that I'm hearing from our clients and from our alliances is the need to focus on vertical solutions. And what I mean by that is really thinking about how do we take the from a subsector to sector to industry level of depth and incorporate that into our client solutions so that when we're going and suggesting ideas, we're really bringing that level of expertise. So that's definitely number one. Number two is the product roadmaps. This space is getting a ton of R&D. And so really understanding from our alliances, what's important for them? Where are they innovating new feature sets, new products, new capabilities in their tools really helps us become better strategic advisors. And so that was just an awesome opportunity for us. And the third big takeaway was that getting everyone together is just so important. I know we've been off of Zoom for a while, but just having the chance for everyone to get together, talk about clients, talk about issues, and think through those as a group was tremendously valuable for the team. Maybe Ron, I can turn the table on you. What were some of your key takeaways from the session?
Yeah, I mean, firstly, I completely agree with all three of yours, especially the one on verticals, because, you know, as a practitioner in the software space, this is coming up a big deal. Maybe two more I would add to that. One is the degree of commitment in the enterprise. You know, being someone in AI, I kind of naturally assume that I am indexed overly towards AI. But to see the rest of the market actually be exactly where we are and as excited as I've been for the last couple of years is amazing. The second was the time to get to production ready was a topic that came up a lot, but it dawned on me that it's not just the people that have the best talent or the best data. It's those that are also willing to take the risk and actually traverse into a space that they haven't done before that are moving the fastest.
Yeah, those are really good insights. I mean, I feel like just that it was a little bit cathartic too, just to have everyone sort of say, yeah, this is hard. We understand that scaling is going to be a challenge. And these are some things we can really try to tackle together as a team, I think was a great sort of moment for everyone.
Absolutely. So Jim, you know, our friend, chief futurist, actually, Mike Bechtel, mentioned at the summit that as AI moves from startup to scale up, multi-party alliances and ecosystems will be crucial for AI. Do you have any thoughts of how this will happen?
Yeah, I mean, we've been having great conversations. And if you think about sort of the evolution of the AI value chain and sort of where clients are spending their money and where their investments in R&D are happening, there's really the stitching together of different capabilities. And some of our alliances have these capabilities built together on single platforms. Other parts of our alliances have best of breed solutions for different elements of this AI technology stack. And so what we're going to really be trying to do is help clients understand where to bundle these technologies together and where to get the most value for their investments in this space. And I think it's really important to understand like which alliances differentiate in different areas. And so I think that's like a super important aspect of, you know, our role as technology strategists and advisors to our clients going forward.
Yeah, makes sense. You know, for someone like me who works primarily in the software sector, I think for a hot second, there were people who suggested that SIs and software companies didn't actually need to work that much together anymore in a world of generative AI. But actually we've discovered it's completely to the contrary. You know, the ability to combine technical depth, industry expertise, and just the raw capacity to drive these business outcomes is now more critical than ever. The other thing is that software companies are now evolving their relationship with us. For example, they need access to high quality training data. They need access to high-quality eval data sets. And so I find us collaborating even more, not just on the commercial aspects, but now even on product. So I think, you know, we're getting deeper and deeper together with our alliance partners.
Yeah, I think you get a great point. Like, I love the fact that people were thinking, you know, we wouldn't need a systems integrator to help figure out how these solutions get together. I think the more we innovate in this space, the more we're going to find the importance of that sort of business to technology translator to figure out how these things fit together and get the requirements right. There isn't an easy button for AI that you just click and suddenly you're up and running across the enterprise. And I think that's where the, you know, SIs like ourselves really play a really critical role for our clients.
Absolutely. Well, Jim, this has been an amazing episode. Thank you so much for joining us. And I also know that you're going to be coming back as a host very soon. So we'll have you on the other side of this conversation, and we're going to have a few of our industry leaders join you as well. So for all of our listeners, stay tuned. And Jim, thanks so much for being a part of this episode.
Yeah, thanks so much. Really excited to be hosting with you this year. And I'm really excited that we're going to spend a lot of time with our industry leaders, because as we mentioned, this industry level of depth and understanding and tailoring of solutions is really important in terms of driving value for AI. Thanks again. Really appreciate it.
Take care.